Thank you. Waku Utu Powerful, life-transforming service in the name that is above every other name, the name of Jesus Christ. Welcome to another moment of hope, moment of grace in the presence of the Almighty. This is Prayers Beyond Boundaries Ministries. I am Evangelist Lucy Wagojiri, the founder and overseer of the ministry. And together with me is my husband and the patron of the Prayers Beyond Boundaries Ministries, Mr. Lamek Gojiri, Pastor, Bishop, Archbishop, to the glory of God. And together with us here, we have our family that is leading family. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen and amen. It is the day that the Lord has made for us to rejoice and be glad in it. Today being the last Sunday of the month of April, by the mercies of the Most High, the last Sunday of the month of April 2020. Juu ya mambo yote, igũrũ rĩa maũndũ mothe, Ngai akoretwo arĩ Ngai. So we are going to have, last Friday I said 1 hour, it became 1.5 hours. So don't worry, we are going to have a Beyond Boundary service. Of course, we want to control more than last Sunday, but because of the excitement of the presence of God and that the gospel is not locked, you find ourselves going beyond what we are telling you. Kindly bear with us. I know you are also getting very excited by the masses of the Mosai. So ladies and gentlemen, our viewers, we welcome you. Twamunyita ogeni, wherever you are, tuned from Nairobi, tuned from every county of the 47 counties. Where are you watching us from? This is Evangelist Lucy Wagojiri official page, and immediately after we are done, we will post the same to our YouTube. And you can tell your friends, by the way, to subscribe on Evangelist Lucy Wagojiri YouTube. All the past sermons, my Valentine, the Sunday powerful one, it is on YouTube for those who are not on Facebook. And so after we are done, again, this one will be on YouTube. So tell them to subscribe. What the YouTube winner, Evangelist Lucy Wagojiri, you just subscribe. And dear ones, you'll get so blessed because we are here for God. So watching from the 47 counties, may the Lord bless you, keep you, sustain you by His power. The PBB members, wherever you are, praise the Lord, dear ones. This is our Beyond Boundaries service. When it is Beyond Boundaries, we go beyond, we mix languages to the glory of God. So all over Kenya, the favor of God upon you. May He visit you in a special way as you continue to the glory of God. So say hello to all those who are watching all over. All over Africa, different parts. We have Pastor Darlington Taste. Pastor, I am telling you, Apostle, you are amazing. Watching all the way from Cape Town, all over Africa. We have Pastor Isaac and Pastor Rehab watching from Uganda. Thank you so much. All over Africa, tell them God bless you.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
You are blessed.
You're very blessed. Yes. And also all over Asia. Asia, you are there in the, India, China. Thank you. Look at them. Dubai, Qatar, Doha. I am excited. Kuwait. Oh my God, Afghanistan. May the Lord bless you so much. Welcome to a powerful moment of hope. By the masses of the Mosai, all over Europe, my God, from Germany. I love it. Sister Helen, thank you so much. Sister Ann Mula, baby Alice, thank you so much. Everin Kyukyuk, Faith Wamunyeki, thank you. Netherlands, our sister Nancy, thank you so much. Europe, UK, thank you so much. Europe, where you are there, may the Lord bless you so much. Athens, Italy, everywhere. Europe, you are in the hearts of God. God. And karibuni sana. We get blessed together. America, for those who are awake at this time, the hand of God upon you in every state. Thank you so, so much. Mireno Peter from Kansas. I am humbled. May the Lord bless you so, so much. Australia, the farthest. And bado kuna watu wanatufuata. I am humbled. These are listeners that God gave me through the Kameme platform. And I worship God for this. So dear ones, wherever you are, may the hand of God be upon you. I am declaring a new beginning, fresh start. By the time we are done with this, you'll be in another level. So before we make a prayer, join us as we sing another stanza of Waku Abudiwa Niwewe. Waku Inamirero Niwe Mwadani, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Waku Abudiwa. Wakuheshimiwa ni wewe Mungu, wakupewa sifa na utukufu ni wewe Mungu mwenye nguvu, Mungu mwenye nguvu, wastahili heshima zote. Hakuna mwingine wakulinganishwa na wewe wakuabudiwa, wakuabudiwa, wakuheshimiwa ni wewe. Wakupewa sifa na utukufu ni wewe Mungu mwenye nguvu, Mungu mwenye nguvu, wastahili heshima zote. Hatuna mwingine, hatuna mwingine wakulinganishwa na wewe Mungu. Let us bow our heads and thank him. Open your mouth. Ladies and gentlemen, watching us from all over. Some of you are following this from hospital beds. But there is a God of another chance. Some of us are watching this from quarantine areas. I will never forget about quarantine and isolation. Wherever you are watching from, just bow down. Because I know there are moments that you don't know what to tell God. Just tell him you are God. You are God. You are God. Onawaga kugodoge. Some of us are watching us that are losing their jobs. But just if you have nothing to, you don't know how to go about this. No, inamama pia kweraga, you are God. Over all things, you are God. Some of you have your salary cut, you know. Maudumaya, the corona issue has brought so many issues and changes and adore salaries. Igatinio, agimakaga salaries. Maudumakalito hamono. And not only with this corona, with many other issues. Oh, the ground is sinking sad. But on Christ, the solid rock we stand. Kole muadani, just open your mouth and mwere tu baba wekai. In all this, you are God. In all what we have gone through, you are God. Mwere tu, you are God. You are God in my life. You are God in my family. Mwere tu wekai. Just open your mouth. Because what you proclaim will give you power. Rerebo setana mahanda. Whatever you say with your mouth, whatever you proclaim will give you power to continue. In the name of Jesus. Mwere wekai. Father, you are God. Pokea utukufu Jehovah. Pokea sifa Mungu wa miungu. Wewe ni Mungu pamoja nasi. Wewe umeinuliwa. Wewe umetukuzwa Jehovah. Hatuna Mungu aliye kama wewe. Umeinuliwa juu Mungu wa miungu. We worship you. We adore you Jehovah. For the moment of worship we thank you. For giving us an opportunity to speak your word we thank you. For giving us the opportunity, oh God, to share your word we thank you. For giving giving us favor with you, Jehovah. What a privilege. What a privilege. We thank you for giving us favor with these people, my God. All over. Lord, for giving us this favor, we thank you, we glorify you, we praise you in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you that you are, the world is locked down, but the gospel is not locked. We are here to adore you, we are here to praise you, we are here to exalt you, we are here to magnify you. May your name be glorified, may your name be praised, oh God. You are an awesome God. Wakuabudiwa ni wewe, wakuheshimiwa ni wewe, wakutukuzwa ni wewe. Mungu mwenye nguvu, twakupa sifa, twakuheshimu, twakuabudu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. What you have done, no man can do, oh God. For us to be alive is a miracle. For us to be in good health is a miracle. For us to be here worshiping you is a miracle. So we exalt and adore you. You are God Almighty. Thank you for sustaining these dear ones, oh God. These men, oh Jehovah, in all the tough times, oh God. Thank you for supporting these men. Thank you for being their God. Thank you for supporting these women. Thank you for being their God. In the name of Jesus, thank you for supporting these young people. You've been their God, you've been their encourager. We thank you for supporting them. We thank you for the little children. You've been their God and their master. We magnify you, Jehovah. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for Kenya. Thank you for loving our nation. Thank you for taking your place in Kenya. Thank you for all that you are doing in this nation. Thank you for the reports that we hear, God, positive reports. Thank you for your hand upon us. Thank you for the leadership of the nation. You are God over this nation. You are God over the leadership of the nation. You are God lifted over all the world. Could the world be more than me? All over the world, you are God from beginning to the end. We magnify you. Even in tough times, you have proved to be God. May your name be glorified. Lord Almighty, God of all flesh, on this day, Sundays, mahinda ta maya, tukoragwo tururunganite makanithaini, we gather in churches all over the world to adore you and to hear your word. But for these reasons, we are not there. But God, we want to thank you because the church of God is universal. It is everywhere and can meet everywhere. In the book of Acts, kanithawasha managia mesie. And God, we are back to meeting us and share your word, Lord, and magnify you. And we thank you that you are not limited. Oh God Almighty, kuria turewe kwa, you are here to just do all that you can do. May your name be glorified. Now I declare supernatural power over the lives of these dear ones as they follow. Supernatural power over our lives as well. Maodo matage kwane modo, do it as we continue, Jehovah. Netwagwe tekeria other makena we ona nie for your own glory. Shake up hospitals that people may go home. Mass exodus paonetiomelimoyode. Shake up, Jehovah, homes that people may repent of their sins. Shake up everywhere that there be unity and the peace of God everywhere to the glory of your name. Netwagotea, now take over. Take over, take over and reign, O God. Reign, O Jehovah, reign, you are God Almighty. Reign, Dhamaka, Dhamaka netoa kuheogoshi, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we all say,
Amen.
And again we say,
Amen.
Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptations, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen and amen. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hallelujah again!
Amen,
amen and amen. Wakuabudiwa ni wewe tu, Jehovah. So we again join by praising Jehovah to the glory of his name. Amen. Amen. We are praising the living God.
We are praising the living God. We are praising the living God. Hallelujah. Christ. We are praising the living God.
We are praising the living God. We are praising the living God. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ.
Oh, hallelujah, the living God. Amen.
Hallelujah, the living God. Hallelujah, the living God. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ.
Oh, we are praising who died for us.
We are praising who died for us. We are praising who died for us. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ.
We are praising the King of Kings.
We are praising the King of Kings.
Amen.
We are praising the King of Kings. Hallelujah, Jesus Christ.
Oh, hallelujah.
King of Kings, hallelujah, the King of Kings, hallelujah, Jesus Christ.
We clap to the Almighty, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, 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 and amen. Now one, already another one stanza of my national anthem, to the glory of God. Soon again, my national anthem.
Gaiwa kwa
you know, I'm wondering, could there be anyone seated right now? You are following us. Are you a PPP member? Where are you? Where are you? Sister Susan, could you be seated? And our children or in bed? Anyone who can. And by the way, you can connect this to the TV. You just connect to the TV and you watch from the screen, big screen TV. Yeah? So wherever you are, can you join me? If you don't understand this language, just come up to Jehovah. Amen.
Amen.
Hey, Gaiwa. Gaiwa kwae, amage ganyae, gaiwa kwae, gaiwa kwae, amage ganyae, gaiwa kwae, gaiwa kwae, gaiwa kwae, amage ganyae, gaiwa kwae, kwae, gaiwa kwae,
Yeah.
Cristo. Creo amor de Narosio. To you, Jehovah, be all the glory, praise, and honor we say. And we come to Jehovah, resume, we'll get back there in our churches. Kanitha kuri othiaga no tureshoka, but for now muhujia nawe mutongoria wa nyimbo nawe mwiki atia. But don't you worry, I am a build boundaries preacher. Build rajitaraire muthuri atongorie nyimbo ni kuremire jetaraire ciana itongorie ona matingihota gutongoria cia gikuyu. But I'm build boundaries, eh? So that is okay.
That's why even the ministry is, they say,
it is beyond boundaries to the glory of God. Amen.
Right.
Father, we magnify you. Have your way. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Now, Sunday school. Get seated. Our children.
Time for our children.
Yes, it's time for Sunday school. Watoto wote bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
Chanduta is here with our session ya Sunday school sasa, sindio? Kila mtu, are you ready everyone?
Yes.
Children of God, will you sing hallelujah?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. You come closer so we have this. Mention them, Sunday school here.
Yes. Moses, come.
You represent all the other children.
Yes. Representing the whole.
Greet them, children all over the world. Imagine.
Salimi,
others watching you from Germany, Moses, right now.
Salimi, all over the world.
Yes.
Yes.
Muranga, they are watching. Kanafrida, they are watching. JJ are watching in the US.
And they also join you.
And they also join me.
Tell them to join you
in the singing.
Whatever you have, please can you join me in the singing?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, we start. He's got the whole world in his hands. 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 He's got mommy and daddy in his hands. He's got mommy and daddy. In his hands, he's got mommy and daddy. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got your sister and brother.
In his hands, he's got your sister and brothers. In his hands, he's got your sisters and brothers. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got your aunties and uncles.
In his hands, he's got your aunties and uncles. In his hands, he's got your aunties and uncles. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got the whole world.
In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
Yes, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got your mother. He's got your father. He's got your brothers, he's got your sisters, he's got your aunties, he's got your uncles in his hands. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So last Sunday we talked about fear. We mentioned that God will never leave us nor forsake us till the end of age. He's always with us. And that was in the which book? Matthew chapter 28 verse 20. That was our memory verse. That he'll always be with us till the end of the time. Now today we are going to study about patience. Tell your friend and your mother patience, and your sister patience. No, you miss your friends in school, you miss your uncles, you miss your shosho and guka, but we should remain patient. We should have patience in us. Just like who, I'm going to give you two characters in the Bible. I know you know about Abraham. Who is Abraham? Who was Abraham?
Isaac's father.
You know, I clap for the father. Abraham was Isaac's father. But again, Abraham was father of faith. Yes, he's father of faith. He had a very strong faith that everything he has been promised by God, it's going to come to be. Itakuja ku tendeka na itakuwa, like it's going to happen. He had a very faith ni nini na Kiswahili?
Imani.
Alikuwa na imani. Ati kila kitu ameahidiwa na Mungu, it shall come to pass. You know Abraham was 100 years, and he was told by God that you are going to be father of many nations. He's going to be father. Asa, saizo hakuwa na hata na mtoto mmoja. Asa anashanga, ai, asa nitakuwa aje father of many nations, and I don't even have a baby or a child. But at that time he was how old? 100. Guka na hata pia.
But he was not
strong.
Down like this.
Yes.
Oh,
he was strong. Hallelujah.
He was strong.
Yeah.
He was
not down.
Yeah. He was not bent.
Abraham did bend.
Not like this.
Not like this, Guka.
Was walking.
What about the wife
walking?
The wife
called who? Elizabeth. Sarah. Sorry. Yes. Elizabeth
is the mother.
Yes.
Yes.
John.
Good.
Good. So Sarah pia yeye alikuwa mzee and she was 90 years old and she dead. But again they were patient because they were promised by God that is going to give them who?
A child.
Yes. Even at their old age. And they were given who? A baby called Isaac. See, the promise of God ilikuwa fulfilled. Kenya Mungu aliwaahidi hivi? After many.
After many years that God had promised them a child, he fulfilled his promise and
gave
them a child.
Wow. Yes. Yeah.
That's very nice. That's Moses. Another character in the Bible. Who? Joseph. Do you remember Joseph?
Yes.
Joseph. Well, who's Joseph?
Joseph. There are two Josephs. Jesus' father.
Yes. And the other Joseph.
The one was betrayed by his brother.
Yes. Yes, and he's also Joseph. He had a coat of many
colors.
Yes.
Like a rainbow.
Yes, like a rainbow. He was given a coat of many colors. But Joseph was, you have said he was betrayed by his brothers. You know, how was he betrayed?
Joseph mm-hmm. was told by his father uh-huh. to go and give the brothers food.
Yes.
And then, but the father gave him a colorful coat. Uh-huh. And then when he was going, the brother saw him from far and got jealous.
Uh-huh.
Since they know that the father loves Joseph the most. Because he was the most obedient. So
He was obedient.
Uh-huh. So then they planned to sell him.
Yes. To which country?
Egypt.
Yes.
So then they took a ship, they killed it,
and then
they put blood on the coat and then said that it was killed.
And it was a lie. You know that whole story? Yes, and you know
where did they take the coat?
They were saying to their father, Joseph has been killed.
And the truth was they had sold his brother where?
To Egypt. Just for money.
He was sold to Egypt. But in Egypt, Joseph was patient. He had because he was a dreamer. You know he used to dream?
He was taken to prison.
Yes,
from then Pharaoh had Pharaoh said he had a different weird dream. So
yes.
Then he said any of the wise men who understand my dream, he called for any of the wise men who understand my dream.
When you interpret,
yes. So then one of the soldiers said that Joseph knows about the dream. So then Joseph was brought to Pharaoh, and then he explained what the dream is.
Yes, that's what happened. Patience from the pit of Ileka well to the prison to again to the Pharaoh's like kwa palace, White House.
Almost to the
he
just
a leader.
Almost to become a king.
That that patience. He was patient enough to wait upon the Lord. During, even in his hard times, hata yote nyalipitia, akarushwa kwa shimo, akaenda kwa jela, nuko kwa jela kulikuwa na watu wabaya, akapelekwa hadi akakuwa king. The same to Abraham. Abraham, he didn't have a son. He waited, he moved from his country. He waited upon the Lord, and even he was given a son because of patience. So during this time when we are at home, as we just have patience that we are going to see our friends, we are going to go back to school, we are going to enjoy ourselves. You know, people who used to love to going to malls and swimming and all that, and go to Sunday school. Because we miss you so, I miss you so, 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 so much. Akina Daniela nimewa miss sana. Akina Shiko nimewa miss. Shiro, nyinyi wote, wote nimewa miss. Akina nani mwingine, Mwangi, Hoplin, nimewa miss sana, sana. So we still have to fumilie tu kidogo as we obey and the directives of the government. Wash your hands, don't touch your face, don't go outside so much, and put on a what?
A mask.
And then what else? Don't
put on gloves and keep social distance.
Yes, you keep social distance. Yes. And so our memory verse today, it's going to come from the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 12. At which book?
Romans chapter 12 verse 12.
Yes, and the Bible says, rejoice in hope. Again?
Rejoice in hope.
Yes. Be patient in turbulences.
Be patient in turbulences.
And be faithful and persistent in prayer.
Be faithful and persistent in prayer.
Yes. Rejoice in hope. Rejoice. Hata kukuwa na mashida mingi mingi, furahia wakati wote. Alafu, uvumilie kuwa na utulivu wakati wenye kuna mashida, kuna mawingu, unaona inakushake. And also, you continue in to be faithful and persistent in prayer. Amen. So we are going to finish with a song, another song, okay?
And then you pray for all the children, tell us your name, okay?
Yes, okay, we are going to sing. This is the day,
this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. Oh, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
This is the family,
this is the family that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in us, and be glad in us. Oh, this is the family that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in them. This is the family that the Lord has made.
Wow, will you pray for the children? Okay. Will you pray? Moses, will you pray? You want to pray for the children?
Thank you for God to protect them,
yes. To lead them, to heal those who are sick, yes. In the name of Jesus. So there Amen. We are. Join us everywhere kindly. Let us pray for all the children. Others don't have food, others don't have parents, but the children belongs to God. Shall we?
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I come before you this day. We thank you this day, oh God. Thank you for protecting us even as we slept in the night, oh God. Thank you for protecting every child, oh God. Thank you for protecting everybody, oh God. And thank you for protecting us from coronavirus, oh God. Even as today we worship you, oh God, it shall be a wonderful service, oh God. Even those children who are watching live, oh God, protect them, cover them in the blood of Jesus. Those who are sick, oh God, those who are lacking food, oh God, provide for them, oh God. Heal those who are sick, oh God. And coronavirus, oh God, please, if the coronavirus, oh God, please let it stop in Jesus' name, pray.
Amen. 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 Wonderful.
It's amazing. Thank you so much.
So teach us at the school your names and then you go. Hey, I'm Teacher Nduta from Prayers Beyond Boundaries Ministries. I teach together along with Teacher Tabitha, Teacher Georgina, Teacher Wangarenjeri, Teacher Lucy, all other teachers.
Teacher Faith.
Teacher Faith, what we work together to, and we team up to also bring the good news or share the good news to and the love of Christ to our children, even at home. Continue teaching them, encourage them in every area, wherever they, whenever wanna feel wako down, just remind them that Christ is there and He'll never leave us nor forsake us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Wow, a big clap for our Sunday school. Thank you. So Sunday school can now go to their tents. Sunday school muende. Mam compadre ile wote, let's clap for the children. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. This is the last Sunday of the month of April. By the mercies of God, we are alive. By the mercies of God, the gospel is not locked. By the mercies of God, we are strong and we praise Jehovah from all over. Hallelujah. Amen. You can join me and we say, we give you all the glory. Worship you alone, you are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. So let us now join with the Sarakei to sing one stanza of the song Uninyunyiziai Maji Wakati wa Ukame. Amen.
Amen.
You know what that means? It is when there is famine, when there is nothing, when we are going through tough times, it is God Almighty. You know what He does? He refreshes us. He is God Almighty. He refreshes us. Ato itagereria mae. What did you say, Brother Moronyo? Itagereria mae. O gato he hinya koroine. E nane tokwedete. Let us just tell God that He's been there for us. He'll forever be there for us. Tumwambie tunampeda. Can you sing one stanza only? Thank you so, so much. I know our guitar and keyboard guy. Where we tipage too, don't you worry. We are the old boundaries. Uninyunyiziae maji wakati wa ukame, huashi ni nyauke ona kupenda. Say it again. Uninyunyiziae maji wakati wa ukame, uashi ninyauke ona kupenda. Mwambie Yesu na kupenda na kupenda. So that we can hear the word again. Alafu we are going to give also. Tunaposikia neno we will give. Tutapeana kwa makanisa yetu. Please make sure that uko na namba ya mchungaji ya kanisa kwenu.
uko na namba yenye waweza tuma pesa, wengine ni chakula mutapereka after this, but make sure that you give. Makanithani mararuta, tumaruta wera mwige mono, with salaries to pay, with buildings to pay, now do my game. And because of lockdown, kuraga kurutuo, though we trust in God, nitoko hata ku understand, we understand about giving, and at the end of it all, we'll have the Holy Communion. Every Sunday, we are going to have Holy Communion until further notice, and to the glory of God. Amen. With that one, ya kusema na kupenda Bwana Yesu,
na kupenda,
haleluya,
mnyenyezi wangu, ona
together to wake you, for us to hear the word of God for 10 minutes, I'll request our patron, because I'm giving the word to start with, then our patron, my husband, he'll come in also, tell us, teach us about giving. He'll tell us that more about that. But for this, I want to prepare us for hope and grace as we continue. In all humility, I request you, sir, to pray for the word of God. Let us all start and we pray for the word of God.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, we give you praise, we give you all the adoration because you're a good God. Thank you, Father, for you have loved us so much that you have given us your word, that by your word we will live victorious lives, that your word that is living and powerful, that if we apply the word and speak your word and believe and get to have this knowledge, the revelation knowledge of your word, we will not be defeated. Thank you, Father, for all that you have done for us. You have already anointed your servant, O Father, and I know that, Lord, even those who are watching us, they will receive this word, and it's a seed that is going to be planted in their hearts, and this word will bear fruit. We give you praise and glory because you're a good God. This I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. The word to read the word of God is a Dutta from Psalm 121. To the glory of God. Is it Dutta? I hope can read. Can be seated, hopefully, to read the word of God. I've given you the new living. I'm a whichever that one. Psalm 121. Yes. Yes. Psalm 121.
Kupenda, hallelujah. Kupenda, mnyenyezi wangu. Ona, kupenda.
Okay. Psalms 121, verse 1 to 8. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
Hallelujah. And we agreed after we are done, we said, well, these are the words of the Lord. Can you do that, all of us?
These are the words of the Lord.
And now we go to independent church. I taught you in Kikuyu. Isho nisho shugo shia mwadhani. Let us go.
Isho nisho shugo shia mwadhani.
And others at the back say, Gayarogo sho. The best guys, Morris and Leon. Morris, ni idio mtasema, Gayarogo sho. They say, Isho nisho shugo shia mwadhani. Let's go. We have built boundaries. Isho nisho shugo shia mwadhani. Amen. Wow, that's a good one. When you do that, we become beyond boundaries. These are the words of the Lord. Thank you for doing good, Kikuyu. God bless you so much.
Kupenda Bwana Yesu. Kupenda mnyenyezi wangu.
Jesus' name, I take this opportunity to give you this word of God for just a few minutes. It is about the truth in your circumstances. The truth in your circumstances. Uhoro uri uri wa ma thini wa maria turagerera na maria tugeragira. There is what we go through, and there is the truth of that and the truth in that. What is the truth in our circumstances? What is the truth when we are going through circumstances, difficult circumstances, what is the truth? Our patron and my husband said last Sunday that there is a difference between facts and the truth. The fact is, the fact is you are sick. But the truth is, more than 2,000 years ago, Jesus went to the cross and his body was broken for our healing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please let me have an amen to encourage me.
Amen.
So there is the difference between the fact and the truth. But what is the truth of your circumstances? Ladies and gentlemen, someone said that God fits the trial to the person so that what happens to me can't be compared with what happens to you. When we are going through trials, God makes sure that our trials are not the same. Magerio maria mudu ageragira thini wa muturire wa thi matihananaga. What I have gone through to be who I am today is totally different from what you have gone through for you to be who you are today. I know my pastors are following this. Thank you so much, Pastor Amos, Pastor Susan, Pastor Julius, our doctor, head of education, Pastor James, Reverend James Mwangi. Thank you so much. May the Lord bless you. My pastors, Jenga, where are you? Those who are supporters in the gospel, Sister Lucy, Sister Shiloh, you know, all these people who support us, KRA, who supports us in the gospel as we preach the gospel. So maudu maria ni dana gerera in my life are different from what you have gone through in your life. Can you focus on me, Maurice? Just focusing on me only for now. What I have gone through, what you have gone through is totally different to get to where we are today. And somebody said that God fits the trial to the person so that whatever happens to somebody, to this one, is different from this. No, though right now we have a global challenge, not only magerio tare the same in the face of the earth, new doa corona everywhere. But in personal lives, in our personal lives, whatever we are going through, omodo, agera dena wake wemwene. Some of you are trusting God because you are going through trial. You are unable to pay house rent. No house rent yaku ne agiri dato. Where somebody else, yours is 3,000. Somebody else, the house rent is 10,000. Another one is 50,000. The problems and the trials we go through are different. Ladies and gentlemen, truth in our circumstances. God is not on trial during our trials. Somebody hear this. God is not in trial during our trials. Hindi ya turagerera maudu marito, Ngai ndakoragwo thi akigerera maudu macio. When we were growing up and in the days of revival, patron, in early 70s, don't ask me where I was in early 70s, but there was a woman full of God who sang in Kikuyu, a song in Kikuyu. Maithari mayadera itano ewe hitho yamo, modo adeno ehitho nowe do hitheka hitho. Maithari mayadera itano because she was saying, "Ye majosi mimi nalia Jehovah, wewe ndiye unajua shida zangu. Watu wengine waweza kosa kujua, lakini wewe Mungu unajua shida zangu." Why? Because our trials are different. We go through different circumstances, but God is not on trial during our trials. Our struggles are not all the same. Because we have a heavenly Father, nitore Ngai wa iguru, who fits the trial to the person. Maundu maria Ngai etikiritie ngerere ndangitikira ungi. Different people go through different trials. Why? God has his own ways to train us, to teach us when we are going through all this. The Bible talks about that in the book of James. And when we are going through these circumstances, the truth is Psalm 121. The psalmist said, "I look up to the hills. where does my help come from? Negotira my daughter is a mine. Oteyo akwa umaganako. Oteyo akwa umagakore Jehovah, the creator of the heavens and the earth. Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow Christians, your help, my help, comes from the Lord. Even when we go through the trials, the truth is our solution is in the Lord, the creator of the heavens and the earth. True than your circumstances. I'll not read, but I will, you go read about the book of Exodus. In the book of Exodus, chapter number 5 and chapter number 6, God sent Moses to go and redeem and deliver the Israelites. And God told him, you perform these miracles, I'll be with you, Moses, and you'll do so much. Moses akaenda, aka perform zile miracles, lakini the deliverance of Israelites were delayed. So what did Moses do? Asho kire kure gai akiria gai. Why do you do this to me? Why did you send me? Why did you do this to me, oh God? Musa kioria gai shioria nyige. As in, kayo regete kumahonoki aneke, kumaruta aneke. He was asking so many questions as if God did not speak to him. When we are going through trials and when our prayers are delayed in being answered, we ask God so many questions. But the Lord has told me the truth in our circumstances is that Jehovah is our provider. Jehovah is our solution. Jehovah God is our God. Muthenya kana otuko, day and night. Can I hear an amen at the back? Can I hear a hallelujah all over Kenya?
Amen.
That he is the solution day and night in our going and in our coming back. And you know what? When Moses was there wandering with Aaron, Madhye Berea for Pharaoh, and they said, God has said you release these people. They performed so many miracles for Pharaoh to release the Israelites. Mpaka Israelites wakaanza kusema, muni sema mutatutoa. God has not done it. When God raised your miracle, it is an opportunity to just look up to him and say, I may not understand, yes, but you are my God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What would you have done if you are Moses? With Moses, we already run millions of people, and yet he's delaying. God had spoken to Moses, yet he delayed the miracle. God, there were so many miracles, and Moses was doing this miracle, Pharaoh was doing his. As Moses is doing this, Pharaoh was doing this. As we continue to pray and trust God, this is happening. This is happening. Where is the solution? All this is happening. Dear ones, we look up to the Lord, to the hills. Our help comes from God. Moses blamed God and accused him of failing to do what he promised. Moses, what we were told by our patron, our pastor, the other time, Moses blamed God. Why didn't you do it? But God was taking his time. Why? In the waiting, we grow. In the waiting,
we grow.
Can I hear that? In the waiting,
we grow.
We grow our spiritual muscles. Mokamba, tuwe amwe niwa iwa. In the waiting, we grow. Rithia tuwetele ile gaye keka odo. Tokoraga theine wakiroho. We grow in our spiritual muscles. We grow in our faith. We grow in our hope when we are waiting. Right now, we are waiting to resume back to our churches. We are waiting to resume back to school. We are waiting to get back to work. We are waiting ati tufike nyumbani by 7 because there is curfew. We are waiting. In our waiting, we should not blame God. Why? Because God is preparing us for greatness. When the Israelites waited, God prepared them for greatness to the glory of his name. Hallelujah. I'm glad that God is patient with us. Gaida nogaga neithwe. Gaida nogagio neithwe kana agatorakarira even when we ask him questions. And there are so many questions. God, why are you allowing all this to happen? Why are you not setting us free? God, you said Moses, through Moses you'll do this to us. Dear ones, haria tokinyete. God, the way he came through for the Israelites, he'll still do it for us. Why? Because he is God, and God is not on trial during our trials. God is not locked when we are locked. God is not at the curfew when we are at the curfew. God is not going through screening when we are going through screening. God is not taking medication when we are taking medication. House rent when we don't have house rent. Now we have to look up to him. He is God, the author and the finisher of our faith. He has every right to be the initiator of our lives. Niwe gutongoria maundu mothe. Can you lift your hand and say, initiator, he will lead me in my life, number one.
He
is the focus of my life.
He is the focus of my life.
He is the director of my life.
He is the director of my life.
Dear ones, we must hear the truth.
Yes.
That is what it means to focus on God. Why? Because he's not on trial. He's not wondering what to do because the world is wondering what to do. Gaida tukaneiro na darigetu oriegweka. He is God over all things and he must be glorified and magnified. When Moses and Pharaoh are waiting, God came through for them. Gayagi oka agituma Pharaoh and also the people of Egypt makigegeara. A time came. On a unit a time is coming. When I'll pay my fees again. When I'll pay my rent again. When I walk on my feet, when everything will change, when I go back to my business, when everything will change in our nation, dear ones, a time is coming. But the question is, are you ready for the magnitude of the miracles that God is coming to perform? Niwe harerie kwamukira irathimo cia Ngai. Niwe harerie kwamukira hinya wa Ngai. Are you ready? Are you ready? Dear ones, God allows some things to happen so that he can take us to another level. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And he has said when we are going through all this, we look up to the hills. We look up to him. Where does our help come from?
Our help comes from the Lord.
The creator of the heavens and the earth. Where does our help come from? Our help comes from the Lord. Ukiumagara uthie no coke, uteithio witu umaga kuri Jehova. I want you to note those things to the glory of God. And as I wind up, dear ones, so that we can also get into something else. As I wind up this to the glory of God, that our help comes from God. The truth in our circumstances. Ni ate Ngai no arituheaga. Wagojiri the landslide, adoguito no kirero guko kuhana. It doesn't matter. Those who are stranded, those who don't know what to do in Europe, you don't know what to do in Australia, in America, you don't know what to do in Asia, you don't know what to do in the mafurorio wa Kenya. Haria tukinyete. There are so many people maronekana ta moe mono. Matioe. I'm here. The Lord told me to tell his people. Ado akwa mutiga kwe goro. I am energizing you. I am preparing you for greatness. And your help comes from me. So we have to focus on God because our help comes from him. Listen to this. The truth in our circumstances. Just settle your mind. The Lord is saying, horeria meshiria maku. Horera, horera, hare Jesu. Horera, horera, hare Jesu. Number two, do not try to understand God. If you want to know about God and understand him, read his word. Number three, go to God and ask him to lead you. Mwire mwathani mie, ninametwo ni gwithondekera, nori ndikwenda urugame nja, watonya ni ugũthondekera, wagĩrie mũciĩ wa ngoro yakwa. Lord, come and make this. Tiga kurera, tiga kuga, I hate the government, I hate this happening. Don't hate nobody. Just hate the devil. Say, God, I know you are there for the Israelites and you made a way for them. You are making a way for me. God is not a respecter of persons. Wait on the Holy Spirit to guide you. Era mwathani roho mutheru ni adogorie. When you are led by the Holy Spirit, you have peace because he's a spirit of peace. Number five, adjust your life. Garurira tumuturire. There are things that you do. Nanyue matike na hia Ngai. Just adjust. There are things that you do. Ukatoma ciari mature na maithori. There are things that you do. Adjust your life. How do you adjust? Let the word of God lead you. Read his word. And dear one, the last two ones, do all he tells you to do. What do we do? What is the truth in our circumstances? Do all that God tells you to do. Jesu araceririo hiki kana ya gariri. Wathira ndibei na kindu giothe. Nyina arera andu aria mararikuo. Do what he tells you to do. Even for us, whatever God tells us to do, let us do it. The last one, let us experience him. God is suffering. Jira cia Ngai tio iyo. Tuhota kumweterera oke na mwena uyu, oke na mwena uria ungi. He is suffering. God is working in and through us. He's accomplishing his work. No ginyarekie maria fagete. He is God. He has to accomplish. His purposes will come to, you know, to pass. Dear ones, I've given you several points. Take them. Believe in him. Let him see him as a sovereign God. He's your provider. He's your protector. He's your healer. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we say,
Amen.
And again, are you okay with that?
Yes.
And now before we get into giving, Patron,
yes.
I know your time now is coming. Church, Bwana asifiwe kanisa. We have a special song. We have a special song, and this song we sing in Hebrew. It is a song between mother and son to the glory of God. Oh. You are ready to clap for mother and son? Mm-hmm. Are you ready to clap for mother and son?
Yes.
To the glory of God. The mother and son. Do you come closer or I come there? I come behind?
No.
I remain there. Thank you so much. Mother and son. You'll be clapping for us, kidogo, eh?
Yes.
Oh.
You can be clapping for us. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for this powerful service. The presence of God is everywhere. And God is visiting us in a special way. Thank you for watching. This is Prayers Beyond Boundaries Ministries. I'm Evangelist Lucy Wagodri, the founder and overseer. This is my family. We are serving God, and the miracles are taking place now to the glory of God. Hallelujah. To honor the truth in our circumstances, we have a God. We have to believe him. We have to love him. He is faithful. So I request my brothers, my sisters, join me as I sing this. Join me as we sing this to the glory of God. Where are you, Baba Neri Wachori in Virginia? Where are you? Join me in this. If you don't understand it, the Holy Spirit will reveal this to you. Just keep thanking God. Just thank God if you don't understand the language. Just keep thanking God. When revival came in the 70s, we sang these songs. Don't ask me where I was, how old I was. But this was. Hallelujah. So I start and you go. Mother and son. Akorino ya idarama. Warea weko. Akorino pefa church. Where are you? Pefa church. Baptist haya. Muko wapi. Full gospel. Where are you? Independent. Where are you? Join me. PPB. Where are you? Join me now to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Ahoro wa moyo didaka nagia tatu mojiteri moyo yo ikire odio yo mueno que pedaga sono dipio yo ikire odio yo mueno que pedaga sono dipio Thank you. Nigeria, Gake na tayi na mwana Jesu, na tayi wa sora uho inata, menya kona doba makito ne. Let us all stand and we make a prayer to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Let us all stand, those who are following us, kindly let us all stand and we make a prayer in the name of Jesus. Let us make a prayer in the name of Jesus, for we will never be put to shame in Jesus' mighty name. We will never be put to shame. God is not on trial and he will never be. Hallelujah. Let us pray, dear ones. Let us pray. It's a serious. Let us pray. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for ministering to us today, that there is grace in our circumstances and that there is the truth in our circumstances. The truth is God Almighty. The fact is we have gone through so much. We have gone through so much as a nation, O Jehovah. In our personal lives, the trials are different, going through so much. But God, we have the truth. And the truth is that God, you are God of our lives. You are God who settles our might. And we are looking up to you as you settle our might, because you are our provider. According to Psalm 121, may your name be glorified. Father, you have told us that we should not try to understand what you are doing, what you are planning for us, but we only need to settle at your feet. We magnify you as we settle at your feet, because Jehovah, you are our provider. You are God, our provider. We lift our eyes unto you. Mafataro maito mwadhani memo koine maku. And we thank you that this has already been released in the name of Jesus. You have told us, God Almighty, in the name of your son, that we go to you. We have come to you now, Father, that you be our God and our Master forever. We have come to you. Watwera terere mwadhani, the truth in our circumstances is that we just go come to you. Toikare korewe. As we lift our eyes unto the hills, our help comes from you. Toikara korewe mwadhani. And we come to you with our families. We come to you with our businesses, with our jobs. We come to you with our nation. We come to you with the president of this nation. We come to you with the deputy of this nation. We come to you with their families. We come to you with the leadership of Kenya. We come to you with our people who are all over the world. We come to you with our people who are foreign from all over. And God Almighty, we present our needs to you. And we know, as you have said, O Jehovah, you are our provider. Our help comes from you. We have just come to you. Watwira toka kolewe mwadhani. Dure hedi ugato shonolithia. May your name be glorified. May your name be praised. For you will never leave us nor forsake us. You have told us to wait on the Holy Spirit and to ask for the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I declare a mighty move of the Holy Spirit in the lives of all of us. Take your place that we may be comforted in the name of Jesus. We have told us to adjust our lives. The truth in our circumstances, we adjust. But and the only way we can adjust is by reading your word. Togaruruke tuikare oria kiugo kiugaga. Togaruruke tugwetekie. The things that we do that are not right, Lord, we are saying no to that. We are keeping them aside and we are adjusting to follow you and to believe in you. You have told us to do as you tell us to do. Oria watwera. Jesus told the mother of Jesus in that way. In Cana of Galilee, Mary said, whatever he tells you, do it. Mary akirado asio Mario hiki ni uria mukwerwa ni Jesu kaigwa. And now, Lord, we turn to you. Whatever you have told us to do, we will do. We will read your word. We have turned to you. We are hoping in you. Our faith is in you. Na nitoe ni utuwekeire. May your name be glorified. And that you are going to experience you because you are suffering. In every situation you are suffering. In every situation you are suffering, we magnify you. Lord, thank you for the healing power. By the stripes of Jesus we are healed. Thank you for this healing. Thank you for the hope you are giving us. Thank you for the grace in our lives. Thank you for the power that raised Jesus from the dead. Everything is changing. And now I declare the peace of God in our minds, in our hearts, in our tabernacles. The peace of God. As we magnify you as God, as we glorify you as God, as we exalt you as God, in our lives, in our families, in our jobs and in our businesses, in our churches, in the lives of these preachers, in the lives of our leaders, we magnify you, we exalt you, and we praise you. Take your place, for you are God Almighty. It is our humble prayer in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We pray.
Amen.
Amen, amen and amen.
Amen.
We are going to sing again one stanza of Uninyunyizia. So we go to the other one. Kama mti kado ya mto, hivyo divyo ilivyo, mnyunyizi wangu ona kupenda. Kama mti twende tena. Kama mti kado ya mto, hivyo divyo ilivyo, mnyunyizi wangu ona kupenda. Jehovah took me through what I've gone through. He told me any prayer that I make, every declaration that I make, there will be the supernatural taking place, and I know this is happening. Etekia mwadhani, etekia gai na etekia kigogo yake. I want you now to thank him
for that miracle that you needed. What is this miracle you needed? Thank Him. It is already done. And because it is done, we join in thanking God. Open your mouths. Open your mouths and just tell Him, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Nakupenda, nakupenda, Bwana Yesu.
Nakupenda.
Hallelujah. Umetutendea na kupenda baba
na
kututembelea kwa njia kuu baba for visiting us we love you
mnyunyizi wangu na kupenda
get seated. We are doing well, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Christians watching from all over. We are doing well. That's your guy, Gururito, the favor of God upon us. And now we want to start giving so that we can give. Giving is very controversial. Why is it? Why do people complain when they are coming to give, when they are taught to give? Why do people complain? And I present to you, somebody said, don't interrupt him, let him speak in English. Wamesema hivyo wengi sana. Let him, don't interrupt. Mom, you keep interrupting. I'm beyond boundaries.
You're beyond boundaries.
I'm beyond boundaries. Yes, and then I don't want to lose my Kameme listeners, especially the old people. Mekere iru wama odo. I don't want to lose
it's
them.
It's also understandable.
But we tutaweza kuweka na hapo kidogo. For now, I want to be that good one. Good, ladies and gentlemen, my husband, the patron of the Prayers Beyond Boundaries Ministries, the teacher of the word. It was powerful on Friday. If you missed Friday, kindly go back to YouTube. I know Sister Sophie has posted last Friday on YouTube. Go back to YouTube. Go back to Facebook. Don't miss Friday. It was so powerful to the glory of God. And I've said you can follow this on the TV, Oyo Creek Connection TV. And at the same time, dear ones, just subscribe to Evangelist Lucy Wangojiri YouTube. Subscribe so that you may be getting so much to the glory of God. So he's a teacher of the word. Let us, for a few minutes, hear about giving.
Yeah.
Welcome, sir.
Maybe before I get to giving.
Yes.
Because I still don't want to lose. Because it's good that we still focus and know. Because even in giving, it's everything to do with understanding God's word. Yeah. It is still understanding, understanding and having the revelation. Without the revelation of God's word, it becomes so difficult because even if you try it in your own efforts, it still doesn't work. Because it's not God who is stopping this from working. It is us. And it is not God who is actually not allowing these things to happen. Yeah, it is our responsibility. And I still want to insist and encourage each one of us so that we see that. Yes, our help comes from the Lord. And it's good that we continuously see that, that our help comes from
the Lord.
From the Lord. Yeah, and when our help comes from the Lord, it is important now for us to know what is it that He has given us. What is it that we actually are supposed to do? Because we have a part to play. Without us, God will not. And without us, we cannot. Without God, as we cannot.
Without God, we cannot.
Without God, we cannot.
And without
and
us,
without us God
cannot.
Will not. Not He cannot.
Mm. God will not. Not. He will not. So He uses us.
He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we think or
imagine. Or even imagine.
Yes.
Amen.
So even when it comes to giving,
yes,
we have to understand the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
We have to always focus. Mm-hmm. What does the word of God teach us?
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why I'm actually even focusing on this,
mm-hmm,
and I'm not going to dwell on this so much because we have to do what the evangelist has actually said.
Yes.
We have to understand about giving. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but all the same, even as we understand about giving, it is important that we see that in 1 Corinthians, I believe it is, mm-hmm,
Yeah, so that we understand what is it that we already have. Yeah, so that we see that we have already been given the Spirit that gets us to have this knowledge. Should be second Corinthians. Should be second Corinthians. Yeah, yeah. It's good so that we see this. Yeah, let me just turn there. I believe it is.
Kupenda nakupenda Yesu
na kupenda mnyunyizi wangu oya kupenda
nakupenda na kupenda Bwana Yesu.
Give me a minute, says.
Kupenda mnyunyizi wangu ona kupenda
na
kupenda Yesu
na kupenda
haleluya
na kupenda mnyunyizi wangu ona kupenda. So evangelist, just allow me, because it is important because of what you have actually just said. Why is it that we don't have that desire to give? It is not in the nature of the sinful man for us to give. It doesn't come naturally.
What are you saying?
Yeah, it doesn't come naturally. So you have to know what is it that God has given us. It is not. Yeah. You will not have that desire. Yeah, because there is a spirit in money. Money has a spirit. Yeah. And we don't know what God has given us. Because we desire that so much. And it's important for us to get to have that understanding.
Yes.
This is still in line with what we were learning even last on Friday and even on Sunday.
Yes.
And that's why I'm saying that if we do not have that understanding and revelation knowledge of what God has already done for us, we will be trying in our own efforts. Yet we already know that He has already
done it
for us. He is our help. We turn to Him, yes. But He has already done something that we should be actually making use of. So if we don't utilize what we already have in us, then it becomes difficult because we'll be doing it in our own strength. And we struggle and we will try it and we will not succeed.
When we are doing it with our own efforts,
we cannot succeed because that's not God's design. God has already purposed how life should be. God has already blessed us. And the blessing, what does a blessing do? The blessing is to empower us to succeed.
Wow.
Blessing is to empower us to succeed. What are the curses? What do curses do? Curses actually make you not succeed. You don't enjoy the blessings of God.
You will not enjoy. You cannot enjoy that. The blessings when they are curses.
So that's why it is important that we renew our minds.
To know the curses and the blessings.
We renew our minds so that we agree with what God has already done for us in Christ.
Wow.
Because John 1:16, grace and truth came.
Grace and truth came.
But the law was given to Moses. We are not getting to that. But now grace and truth came. So our focus, everything that we need is in Christ Jesus. Every promise is yes and amen.
Amen.
Yeah. If it is already accomplished, we are supposed to be enjoying those promises. Why are we not enjoying it? Because we are not seeing it. We are not understanding what is it that we already have.
That's why it's hard even to give.
Yeah. So it becomes difficult. Even when you come to that area of giving, it becomes an issue.
Wow.
Yeah. Because it's not something that just happens naturally.
Mm.
No. There is always a lot of resistance when it comes to giving. And that's why I wanted to read this scripture. It's actually in 1 Corinthians 2:12. Now we have received, this is for those who have received the Spirit of God, the believers. Now we have received not the spirit of the world. That tells you there's a spirit of the world and the enemy is out there and he doesn't want you to give.
Now we did not receive the spirit of the world, but we received the spirit that is from God, so that we can know all that God has given us.
Hey! Yes, yeah. So that we may know. Let me read the whole of it.
Yeah.
Now we, I'm reading from New King James Version. Mm-hmm. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God. He's in us. If somebody doesn't have the spirit of God, you will not know.
So it we have impossible. Not received the spirit of the world.
Yes.
You
yeah.
know how
when we get born again, we have.
It is not that spirit here.
Yes.
We have received the spirit of.
Of God.
Of God. Yes.
Yeah. Why? Why? Yeah. That we might know. It's good to underline that.
That
we might know. And you see, might know is if you have the desire to know. You have you can have the spirit of God. But if you don't have the desire to know, you will not know. But you have the spirit of God in you.
That's why there is that you might know.
Yeah, that's why it's written that you might know.
All that the God has given.
That have been freely given to us by God. The things that have been freely. God gives us everything freely.
So without the spirit of God.
Yes, you will not know.
The other spirit is kwena roho maitamere. Roho wagukorwa wadoi wagukodheno.
Yes.
That deceives us.
Yes. And you know, that's why I said there is a God of this world.
Yes.
The prince of the air.
And that is the
He has an agenda. Unfortunately, dear ones, we blame God. Yeah. And we see like the one who is causing all this to happen, these things to happen. Like even now, even when it comes to giving, why is it that we don't have that desire? Yeah. It's because we don't have the understanding. And we need to see that. And we can only see through the word of God.
Amen.
Yeah. So that you get to have that revelation. Have the understanding. The Spirit of God gives you now the understanding, the ability to understand. That's why grace and truth came.
Yes.
And if we think the way it was in the Old Testament, we'll be trying to bring in that which was in the old that cannot be brought into the new covenant.
So the Old Testament, we have
the new covenant that has better promises.
Better promises. Yes. Yes.
This new covenant is what we need to be focusing on. And everything is in Jesus Christ.
That is the Old Testament. Yes. Now Jesus gave us a better covenant.
Yes, we have a better covenant.
And grace and truth came with Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
And the spirit of this world,
yeah.
spirit of this world, the spirit of God. And the spirit of God,
without that you will not know. And you must have that desire. Yeah. So that we renew. Because you see, when it comes even to the area of giving, we normally don't want to give. Like it was even with me. I've given that example.
Yeah.
And many others, even those who are watching. Even those who are
watching. You know that? What happened that you all of a sudden
This came through the revelation.
The revelation of the spirit.
Of understanding.
The spirit of God.
I was still born again.
Yes.
Even then.
But
I was getting into my pockets. Because I was not valuing it. Yeah. I was just giving because it's time to give. But I was not giving because of understanding. I didn't have that revelation. Today, because that cannot change unless you have that desire. You have the Spirit of God in you so that you have that understanding and you start giving. And when you see like now what is written in Luke 16, Luke 16:10, that money is the least form of faithfulness.
Luke 16:10. The person is sure.
It's the least form of faithfulness.
Pattern, what does that mean? If money is the least form of faithfulness, nikuga agikorwo ndungihoke kana besha ni kindu kiria githe muno ona ndwagwo ni kwihokerwo family.
Yeah.
Ndwagwo ni kwihokerwo gari.
Yeah.
Tondu agikorwo besha ndwagwo ni kwihokerwo maundu manene ni Ngai.
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Yeah, the thing is, it's the least form of faithfulness. Why? Because if you cannot trust God with your money, atibigehega ibesa siyako, how will I trust Him again? Yeah, when it comes to healing, how will I trust Him in my marriage? Yeah,
wow, I cannot
begehega ibesa siyako. If I cannot give, if I cannot have that faithfulness in trusting God with my money, which is the least?
Yeah,
He has given us everything. So when we don't understand, when we don't understand, it actually becomes now a problem to us, not because of the enemy, not because of God, it is because of our lack of understanding. So this freedom, when you know that money is it has a spirit, the mammon, it has that spirit. It's still there in that scripture, Luke 16. But it is important that now when you start giving and have that understanding, because it comes through the renewing of the mind.
Yes.
You have the Spirit of God, you renew your mind, and you exercise. You have to do it.
We have to keep doing it.
It never failed on me. Pap.
Wow.
Yeah. Even when you are giving, I was feeling bad. You are my wife and I love you.
Yes.
Yeah, but I was feeling bad that why is that you're giving all this money?
Go support ministry. We go work in a ministry.
Yes.
There are support.
Yeah.
We go need to have a shiga. No, we support. Can we carry? We cannot carry for a shiora. But can you tell, give a testimony of what you want to get? The more financial. Can you go get
it? The
more shara. The when the more shara, money neko get
it. Yeah, that is the thing. Yeah, because I was not understanding it. So even when it came to issue of tithing, I was not giving faithfully because I still didn't have the understanding.
Corona taria do a shiora.
There are many teachings that we need to have actually. In us that we need to understand that we might not be able to explain all of them.
You'll be giving us every Sunday.
So it's important for us to have the Spirit of God in us and to have that that knowledge so that we desire and then take action on it. That's how I came now to accept now to be giving. Today I have the freedom. I don't
give
with that. Yeah. Long time ago, I would not even have given 1,000 shillings.
The same things are happening today.
I'm sure even those who are watching, many of us. And you spend the money elsewhere freely.
But you cannot give.
Yes.
Giving
God was an issue. Because the enemy does not want you to do that.
Yes.
So, dear ones, it is important that you understand and see that. When you're giving to God, you're not giving to the preacher. You're not giving to the church. Yes, the church will need that money, sure. Because, of course, there are things that the church needs to do and it needs that money.
Yes.
But the motive of giving, give out of love, and you give knowing that you're giving to God.
Yes.
This money, as you're giving through the ministers, the priests, you are giving, but it's being received by Jesus. It can only come through them.
But
you're giving God. And you're saying that I trust you. I trust, even if this is the least form of faithfulness, I trust you with my money. I trust you in everything else that pertains to my life.
Yes.
Whether it is my marriage, whether it is the issue of health, I am trusting in you. Because if you don't trust God with your money, that which is least, then it will be very difficult for you to trust God when to come to other areas of our lives. So it is important because that is the root. In Romans 11:16,
about
the first fruits.
If
the first fruit is holy, if the first fruit is holy, then even the branches will be holy.
Romans chapter
11.
If the first fruit is
holy, then
everything else.
Everything else will be holy. So if you don't start with that root,
tithing,
and you're giving, and you're giving out of love, you're giving because you know that you're giving to God because you love Him, and you know that He first loved you. Yeah, you'll be giving cheerfully. It will be joyful. And you will not even be giving out of necessity. What does that mean?
Mm.
It means that I'm giving because I am now fearing if I don't give, something bad is going to happen to me.
Wow.
That
wow.
was in the old.
That was in the Old Testament.
That was in the Old Testament.
But we give now, because we are blessed.
We give, we are blessed to be a blessing. Yes.
We are blessed.
But I give out of now that understanding, that knowledge that has freed me, that I give and I even desire to give.
Yes.
Yeah. And it becomes now joyful, knowing that now as I give, God is also going to supply. There is no lack in the kingdom.
There is no lack in the kingdom.
For anyone, there is no lack in the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
At all.
Thank you,
because
Jesus.
Because Jesus came. Yeah. He became poor that we be made rich.
Yes.
Yeah. That we be made rich. So you can only be made rich if you have also that knowledge. And you know that you're giving to him.
To him,
he's the one who is receiving.
Enewo.
So it is important that we look at this. We might not do everything here.
That was the beginning.
Yes.
We are going we'll to catch continue. Up with that even as we continue.
Yeah, but it is important that you have the Spirit of God in you.
Yes.
Because if you don't renew your mind, your heart will not be changed.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
If you don't renew your mind.
Yes, yeah. You purpose to get to the Word, read the Word,
change
your mind.
Yes.
By agreeing with the Word, God will change your heart. And your heart will be changed gradually. And you'll be enjoying even as you're walking in the in these truths.
Amen.
Because God's grace empowers you to do all that which you cannot do without Him.
So abundance yukaga when we believe in the truth.
Yes, you believe in this truth.
Hallelujah.
And not hoping that God is going to do. Believe that it's already done. Now take your responsibility.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So, dear ones, even as you give, I'm not saying that you give to PPP.
Yes. I'm saying we are giving to our churches because what we are wearing Makanisa to your churches. And don't be waiting for Sunday. You can also give in the course of the week, you know, or your pay bill, hana. You can even take yourself to that kanitha, uge to tiroka kanitha, but I've brought this envelope. New doa shiana ita ita gyo, new doa bili rehago, new doa whatever. All over. If you don't give, can you start today? And give because God loves a cheerful giver. Oh, koi mura karuna duri gani kurasi ora gatiga. Papa tu ni mweje ora yaterere. How come? Eto ai kaniri na wena tokea beli yama odore. Like going to a safari, garigu tuto tihede tado kaga. Ega doko oka diga stage. Gai karaha doje tereire gari dini wasoko na irofi. Grogoni. Oga daka masini yoki otowale. Then inafanya namna even in honeymoon, during honeymoon, gari inaharibika. There were so many challenges that needed money. Keke nekire iruwa, ane meakire, neto sera iruwa, neke neke. And I discover what you are saying. If you make the first fruit holy.
Yeah. If you make the first fruit holy, everything else.
Everything else will be holy.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Shiko Joe, thank you. God bless you so, so much. You are getting excited. And Moshiri, very excited for watching this. Ivy Mudoni, thank you. The enemy is against giving. She's saying that the enemy is against giving what you are saying. Thank you so much. Emily James, Asante Sana, good to see you. I am blessed. Aroiga, whatever is holy. What you said, what is holy is?
Yeah, the first fruits.
The first fruit, eh? Thank you. Nancy Kamau, God grace, empower us for abundance. Thank you to God be all the glory. Masi Favored, thank you so much. Betty Mwash, Asante Sana, and Mushiri, thank you so much. Aya, Grace Simona, thank you. God bless you, Mr. Simona. Barikiweni, Sana, the heart of God upon you. So much. Nimefurahia sana. Wow. I am humbled. Leadership yote, PBB Mungu wa bariki. Those who are following us from outside Kenya, may the Lord bless you and keep you in Jesus' mighty name. So we are going to sing one stanza of a song. Then we make a prayer and you give to your churches, those who have pay bills, those who are what? You give to your different churches or rather you purpose. There those who not give right now, taru negushoka adhimu ine nageza adome, but immediately after this, giving tiriria wa twara, niriria wa purpose. It is when you set it in your mind, when you purpose
you
in your mind.
You know, that desire, it has to be from your
heart. It has to be from the heart.
Yeah.
To the glory of God.
You know what Proverbs says?
Yes.
Yeah. As a man thinketh,
so he is. Yes.
In his heart.
In his heart.
So is he.
Yes.
Yeah. So if you think that if I give, I might not be blessed the way I'm thinking. If I give, I am giving that which I need.
Yes.
Yeah. And you want to hold that, you want to retain it in yourself.
Yes.
Then, you not be enjoying the blessing.
May the Lord help us.
Yeah.
Dear ones, we want to enjoy the blessings. It is giving time so that we can pray.
Yes,
I surrender, oh. I surrender, oh.
Savior, I surrender. Oh,
it is surrendering that which God has given you. You are giving back to Him.
I surrender. Oh, I surrender. I surrender. Oh, oh, to Thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender.
Oh, can't we make a prayer because of the giving time is over? But we are going. We have still 5 more minutes for the Holy Communion to the glory of God. Pray for the giving.
Heavenly Father, we thank You. You are our source. We trust in You because You have given us all things that we need in this life. Thank You, Father, that everything that we have belongs to You, that You have given us and You have blessed us to be a blessing. We say thank You. Help us through the power of the Holy Spirit that we'll have this understanding, that we get to know that we are giving because the Holy Spirit is our teacher and our guide, and He leads us into all truth, that we will get to understand that we are giving back again to You, that which still belongs to You. But it's out of our heart, through understanding, that we give to You. And we are saying thank You, because You are our source. As we give, we know we are giving and it's being received by Jesus. We say thank You, Father, for all that You have done for us. We know that the enemy is there so that we do not get to have this revelation knowledge. But we rebuke him. And we focus on You. We focus on the Word. Because we have Your Spirit in us,
Jesus.
Your Spirit that You have given us, that we may be able to know that which You have freely given unto us. May this understanding dwell in us. We thank You, Father. As we give, we say thank You. You know we have received it, and we are giving out of love, so that, Lord, we know we are going to receive 100-fold as You have promised in Your Word. We honor You and we adore You because You are good God. We are blessing this because if the first fruit is holy, the branches will also be holy. And we will enjoy everything else that we remain with because you know it is already holy. We honor You because you are good God. In Jesus' name I pray and give thanks.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen. Clap to Jehovah. Do you remember a song? Do you remember a song that we sing in church? I lead in church when we are giving, when people are giving, because giving goes beyond money.
Yeah.
You know, you see, we're going to go, wanapeana kwa watu wenye wana, others give food.
Yeah.
I love receiving carrots, babe. Like now I love receiving igwa, ikwa, you know these. And we take them to church, by the way, because we are blessed differently. And we have seen a domararu ta ikwa, you know, shikegoru wa giri komi. So you give more than even somebody who gave 500 shillings.
Na doiko mamanya tere, kake kuro te tere shidiye tu trahe yana, nigara tuye na piyanyi.
So you don't give so that you can get a lot of money.
Yes,
You give because you love God.
He will teach, not now.
You said
about food prosperity. Because if it doesn't start from the renewing
your
mind, from the Spirit, you will not enjoy, even if you have that much money.
And you see who receives our tithing?
Jesus who receives.
Say that again. You said Holy Communion we receive?
Holy Communion, when we actually receive the Holy Communion, we are proclaiming.
We proclaim.
We proclaim that Jesus died, right? When we are giving our tithes, we proclaim that He lives.
I'll never cease to
As
do
it
that.
Was with Abraham and
Melchizedek. Melchizedek.
We'll not get into that, but I'm saying,
Amen.
I don't give more of my so don't give with the motive of wanting to get more.
Give because you love God
and desire to understand, so that you get the understanding of where you'll have true prosperity.
Hallelujah.
That cuts across everything.
Amen.
Whether you have little money or you have much money, you will enjoy that prosperity.
Amazing. This we will be receiving every other Sunday from our patron, my husband, to the glory of God, patron of the prayers, Behold Boundaries Ministries. And so when I receive Bebeshia with the Bebeshia Metu Go, I keep singing, Gaina Rito Radhi Maga, Radhi Nema Vida Maito, Na Radhi Meme Goda Ito. Tambo tegera na wedo tu ineri giga ineri tola di maga
radhi mema wira maito na radhi mene godaito
As you give today, the days to come, to support ministries, to support families, to support the poor, to support the needy, to support the orphans, to support the gospel as you continue giving. He's already blessed
you.
And now, in Jesus' name, I request that we all stand and clap as we usher in our patron to give us the Holy Communion in the name of Jesus so that we can be done in 5 minutes to the glory of God. Once again, for the Holy Communion. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. Hallelujah, it was to set me free. It was to set me free. Hallelujah, it was to set me free. It was to set me free. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen, 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 amen. Actually, we're just going to continue with what we had in the last last Sunday.
Yes.
Yeah, because as we said, communion we can actually receive even every day. We do not have to wait until Sunday or any other day. Mm-hmm. You can purpose to be receiving the communion every day.
Mm-hmm. But the challenge is when Adoma menyeraga,
Now that one depends by you giving it what. Yeah, if you're not giving it one, even if you take every day, or you take after 1 week, or you take 1 month,
once a month,
it doesn't be a benefit to you. So, but when you are receiving the communion, because we receive, just see that you are receiving from Jesus Himself. It is His body, it is His blood. Yeah, that we are the cup of blessing.
Yes.
See that you are receiving from Him, and you are actually now going to enjoy the resurrected life.
So you have your victory because the resurrection is brought victory.
And you see now, we actually receive the communion.
Yes.
And we do this in remembrance so that we constantly remember and always tell our minds so that in our hearts, this dwells in us. That I am receiving this communion so that my healing, I know, is a guarantee.
Yes.
Even as I actually do other things,
yes,
I know, because God cannot be confined to only one area and think that He's going to heal you because of what you have done.
Wow.
He has many different ways. Yeah. But this is the foundation of it all. Because by the stripes of Jesus, we were all healed.
Wow.
But still, like it is in Isaiah 53.
Mm.
Because He said, that we are healed. So healing is still there. Healing is still there.
Yes.
And it still comes from you.
It comes from you.
You can also have that, like I said the other time,
mm-hmm,
you still have the healing. You can have that health and walk in divine health.
Yes.
Because we are healed.
Amen.
Where do you see yourself? Are you seeing yourself before the cross or after the cross?
Wait a minute. Where is before the cross?
Before the cross, it's you are looking towards His death. Yes.
And after the cross?
After the cross, it's the resurrected
life. It is the resurrected life.
Everything.
So where should we see ourselves?
After the cross.
After the cross. Because the victory didn't just come by the death. The victory came
by the resurrection.
The resurrection is what justified us.
Yes, yeah. And when we do this, to keep partake the Holy Communion, Jesus will be our wake. Ekagai yo nigeza modirikana.
In remembrance
of him.
You know, in most cases we focus on our weaknesses, on our areas where we have failed.
Yes.
And we are told here, First Corinthians 11. This is actually scripture that is actually most led.
Yes.
In most of the times when we have in communion.
Yes.
But we don't focus on this.
Mm-hmm.
Because we focus on our weaknesses and on our unworthiness. Yet we are not supposed to be seeing that.
Mm-hmm.
We are supposed to be seeing what Jesus atoned for us, the victory that is already won. Not where I fail. Because I'm not worthy.
I'm annoyed.
Yeah.
I got annoyed. Yeah. Because of this, is ukarora what? The challenges you are in, will not partake the Holy Communion. So that taking unworthily, I think the best thing you tell them that taking unworthily, tikukorobe muraka dukana umohana, it is when you are annoyed, nikuofataire muno kupartake the Holy Communion, nigetha ikuririkanie egutherie.
Yeah, that's what you are supposed to focus.
Unworthily, nigetha utara have value, utara menya, why are you partaking this? It is when you are weak. In your weakness, it's actually when we need it most.
Yes, of course.
And that's why we've been taking the Holy Communion every other Sunday, because of what is happening all over the world and in our lives. Maudu Maria more than matu diurokeria, we are partaking the Holy Communion to proclaim that Jesus lives.
Yes.
And because he lives, I can face tomorrow, because he lives. All fear is gone, because I know he holds my future, and life is worth a living just because he is. So we are proclaiming that Jesus lives. Now I proclaim it is your victory.
Yeah. So I wanted to read this scripture.
Yes.
1 Corinthians 11. Verse 29.
Mm-hmm.
We'll not expound on it much, because of time.
Yes.
For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot that we can expound on that, but we'll not do it at this time. Not discerning the Lord's body.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know I mentioned about that last time.
Yes.
If you don't discern the Lord's body, what did the body do?
What does discerning the body mean?
Yeah, so that you focus. You focus on what he went through. The scourging and all that. The pain that he went through.
Yes,
because it says that in the next verse. If you're not actually discerning that, for this reason, you see, that is one reason. It's the only reason.
For this reason.
If you're not discerning for your health. For this reason, many are weak and sick among you. And many sleep, of course, meaning death. So for that one reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it is important for us to see that. Yeah. That we are going to discern the Lord's body.
Yes.
Jesus, when he came here and died, he took care of the roots. What was the root of all the fallen world that we are in?
It was sin.
It was sin. Amen. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So his blood took care of the root of sin.
Root.
Yeah.
Root is medigi, Mary.
Yeah. The root of sin has already been taken
care of.
And we are forgiven of all
sins.
Yeah. So that we see we are already forgiven.
Amen.
Past, present, and future.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. So that we don't think that even what we are doing, that we are sinning. Because we always sin. Whether you like it or not, you will still sin without even knowing. Even through your thoughts.
But now the past
that is already taken care of.
Yes.
Jesus took care of that root.
Yes.
So that we see the same thing.
Yes.
So that even when I'm partaking of the Holy Communion, I know forgiveness is already done.
It is done.
I don't have to feel unworthy.
Yes.
Yeah. If I feel unworthy, then that is what is going to cause me to be weak.
But now see yourself worthy.
Yeah.
And we are doing this in remembrance of Jesus Christ.
This is power that we have been given. It's important that we understand that. So we have the root taken care of, and the fruit that came from that root of sin, the curse, that is already taken care of.
Matuda,
masiaroma,
mamehiare.
Yeah, that was
sickness irumishio the kurwara kuhinyereka kurakara kwaga ku horithania ndo ciande kugo gwitua ukahorithania ndo na ugeka kiundu na ni gwitua wituaga icio nicio ni curses ni maciaro ma media mehia but Jesus became our curse
Jesus
adire mudharafai because the Bible says to go to a cast in your heart to mudharafai so Jesus went to the cross
Galatians 3:13
Galatians 3:13 Jesus became our curse So right now we are declaring your victory over sicknesses, your victory over kuboeka, your victory over that it is through the Holy Communion, your victory over reunion, your victory, your way through is this, your consciousness, your victory is through the Holy Communion, your steadfastness, let us not be conscious of maudu maria moru magitukora but we be conscious of the blood of Jesus. What has the blood done? It has set us free. Thank you.
Thank you so much. This is important. Dear ones, go and study more about this. This is life. We feed on the tree of
life.
On the tree of life.
Amen. Yes, amen. Amen. And you share that to the glory of God. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. The blood of Jesus on the cross, it was to set me free. Hallelujah, it was to set me free. It was to set me free. Hallelujah, it was to set me free. It was to set me free.
Oh, I'm sure those who are viewing, you have your bread and you have your cup of blessing. It doesn't have to be the altar wine. It can be any drink, juice, whatever it is. I know we talked about that last time.
Give it value, then it works.
Yes, so we are separating this. We are sanctifying this. These are just symbols. Yeah, but you're sanctifying them to signify the body of Jesus, his flesh, and the cup of blessing, his blood. So as you're partaking, have that in your mind, in your thoughts, so that that is what now is in you. Because as you renew your mind, your heart is being changed. And you'll be having value and you'll be giving worth to what already has been accomplished for us. This is life. We are feeding on the tree of life.
Yes.
Everything.
Your victory is here. Yes. This is your victory. The body of Christ that came from heaven.
Yeah, and don't see yourself unworthy.
Not worthy.
We cannot make ourselves Jesus. Worthy. We have been made worthy.
Worthy, we have been made by the Christ.
So let's receive, receive the bread with thanksgiving. We are thanking God for that he has done for us in Christ Jesus because it's out of his love for us that he sacrificed his only begotten son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for your sake and for my sake. So we are receiving the bread and we are giving worth to what he has already accomplished. For by his stripes we were healed. Healing is in his body.
Take it. If you have it, from you're coming out of that hospital by through this.
By faith.
It doesn't matter what it takes. So partake this. It is your victory. It is your victory. Dialysis. Chemotherapy. This one, your victory. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let's receive the prayer together. You have said the cup is the shed blood. Life is
in the blood.
Yeah. The blood of Jesus is sin free, disease free, poverty free.
Hallelujah.
So you see dere yourself.
Dere merimo, dere vena, dere kuboeka, dere kuhoreka, takamea Jesus that was shed for you. Ogotari.
Yes. So when you receive the cup of blessing, with the bread, we know. Now it was broken for our healing. Now it is the body that was broken, that is already in us, to our ear. Now when we receive the cup of blessing, we have the same understanding. We give thanks and we are giving thanks for what God did for us through Jesus Christ. and we partake the inheritance of the righteous, which is preservation, wholeness, healing, and provision. It's already there. Deliverance, everything is already there for us. And with this, we are sealed. Sealed from any satanic attack.
Hallelujah.
Have that understanding and have
Hallelujah.
That vision in you.
Amen.
So that it becomes part of you.
Amen.
So we receive the cup with thanksgiving together.
Again, we start and we make a prayer.
Yes.
Damu ya mkobozi, damu inatuponya, damu inaokoa, damu imejawa na nguvu, damu ya mkobozi, damu ushindi wetu, damu ulinzi wetu, damu tuibe damu, damu ya mkobozi, damu ulinzi wa Kenya, damu ulinzi wa Europe, damu ulinzi Amerika, damu ya mkombozi, damu ulinzi wa Asia, ulinzi Australia, ulinzi wa Afrika, damu ya mkombozi, damu inanena mema, damu inatenda mema, inatulinda damu ya mkombozi, damu ulinzi wako, damu na jamii yako, mahala kote unaenda, damu ya mkombozi, damu kwa jamii zetu, damu inatulinda, damu ya Yesu, damu ya mkombozi, damu ushindi wetu, damu. Oh haleluya, oh haleluya, damu ya mkombozi, damu.
We receive the victory, breakthrough, open doors, coverage by the blood of Jesus, total healing in our lives, in our families, in our loved ones, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Kenya protected and preserved. Our leadership from the president protected and preserved. Our families protected and preserved. Ah, better things are happening. Miracles have taken place by the blood of Jesus. Father, we magnify you. It is well with us. It is well with our churches. We are resuming soon. It is well with our pastors. We are resuming soon. It is well with our businesses. We are resuming soon. It is well. It is well all over with our jobs. It is well wherever we go. Father, we magnify you. Nethayo koroine. It is well. It is well. And this is done by the blood of Jesus, by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, by partaking the body of Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. To end up our service.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yes,
God
yes.
bless you so much. Makoti kwa
our pastor. And our evangelist.
Makoti kwa our evangelist. To end up the service.
Our
congregation. Our congregation. Makoti kwa our okay. To end up this. Again, I request that I sing another Hebrew song. Only two stanzas with Leon.
Yes.
With my son here. Get seated. And then we do the grace. The service is over
yeah.
to the glory of God.
Yes.
Ashes, ashes, Kwanza, where are you, Jose? Where are you, Penina Musha? Where are you? Dear ones, ashes, chukweni vikombe. Zenye watu walikuwa nakula nazo. Ashes, kaidri. Ashes, kaidri. Halafu, as we sing, watu wakua kwaka muinui mikono. There are those who are, and those they are coming here. If you want to receive the salvation of Jesus, come over, come over. Ashes, nisaidie yeah. kule kado, brother Kieri, where are you? Help me, thank you, Pastor Julius. Thank you so much. Nisaidieni watu wa Roiro, where are you? Nisaidieni bade ile mama, you where are you? Nisaidieni. Aya, where are you? Kaidri, help me, help me. Hawa wote waweze kukaribia watu wa kuokoka to the glory of God. They are coming to receive Jesus Christ. Already the blood of Jesus has been shed for our salvation to the glory of God. Two stanzas. Why are you singing like this, Wagojiri? Because I'm beyond
boundaries.
And I keep saying that we started all this at our platform called Kameme FM, and I worship God for that. When are you coming back to Kameme? In the fullness of time, wakati Mungu atasema rudi, I will be there, so don't you worry, dear
Not
ones
soon.
And so tena again adwagatarama, get ready, get ready, nitayalishieni kabisa, get ready for this to the glory of God. You can clap for me as I do. Churches, we are giving, dear ones, we are giving to our churches, different churches. Pebili ya PBB imeandikwa pale, watu wa PBB imeandikwa pale chini.
if you belong to PBB, imeandikwa pale, dear ones, we put the account to Ekiragaiva. It is tithe, it is offering, it is for the children's home, it is the crusades, it is the building of the church. We put the account that. Yeah? Yeah, no gamodo outside you get the carito ariake, but the pay bill 541476 already in meandikwa parachin. Can you see it scrolling on that screen to the glory of God? And now Jehovah has been good to us. Jehovah has visited us in a special way. He has given us the truth in our circumstances. At the thing they more than marito tragerana me kuere. The truth is otegio vitoku makorewe. The truth is we read the word of God to grow deep. And we are also taught more about giving and also the Holy Communion, the Eucharist. Twera gai ne thank you. He has done wonders. Twasema asante. Twasema
asante.
Twasema
asante. Ewe Mungu. Sifa zetu Bwana. Ewe Mungu.
The greatest miracle is salvation. Wherever you are, the greatest miracle is receiving Jesus Christ. Todo mundo akoragwa niko kuora kwete ne warioka. Sema thank you Jesus for saving me. Thank you for loving me. Today I receive your salvation. I'm a new creature and the past is gone. Write my name in the book of life. I am born again. Amen. We clap for those who have gotten born again. By making that prayer, you are in the kingdom of God. The past is gone, the new has come. Dear ones, the reason why it is for failing to believe in Jesus Christ. But for those who believed in him, he gave them the power to become his children. And now you are the children of God. And even in the course of the week, you can call the numbers. I keep giving the numbers and I want you to call these numbers. These are the numbers of encouragement, the numbers of counseling, the numbers of giving you hope. Whether or somebody else, can you call these numbers? Starting with 0758, they are 100, 400, 100, 500. They are prayers beyond boundaries, ministries, 24 hours. And God is doing wonders. For those who have gotten born again, I seal you by the blood of Jesus. I cancel the plans of the enemy. And Satan, I take authority over you. I remind you, you remain bound away from these lives. In our lives, you cannot influence us in whichever way. You are defeated in Jesus' mighty name. Remain bound. I frustrate your powers. And now this born again, covered by the blood of Jesus, we are more than conquerors. And to all of us who are following, all over the 47 counties, the prayers beyond boundaries, ministries, members, our families, all over Asia, Africa, Europe, America, mwatwikiria adwa komenya through the platform in the radio, I am here to say, riwega wa gai oromoigana. May the grace of God be sufficient to you. May the Lord sustain you by his power. Expect miracles wherever you go, because this is a new beginning for you. There is the truth in your circumstances, sealed by the blood of Jesus, healed by the blood of Jesus, and made whole. God the Lord be with you, together with your families. Together, everything is being resurrected. There is power. There is the move of God everywhere you go. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we say,
amen.
Amen and amen. We clap to God and we do national anthem. National anthem to the glory of God. Higher. National anthem. Swahili. Yamwisho.
Na tujenge taifa letu, ndio wajibu wetu. Kenya istahili heshima, tungane mikono pamoja kazini, kila siku tuwe na shukrani.
Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit is with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Is with us now. Surely goodness and mercy
follow
us all the days of our lives, and we dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Remember, we are doing this because we are in the family, but doing this, remember to keep social. Remember social distance. Remember washing. Remember washing your hands. Remember sanitizing your hands. Remember putting on a mask. Ukienda kwa watu wengi na uko wapi, uko nje, remember putting the mask. But the most important protection of any disease of any or any challenge is
Gwehitha Thakame ya Jesu Nehoheno uruko Uruko na dayo
Tuehitha Thakame ya Jesu. Hallelujah! God bless you. Wageni tukutane pale kwa hema. Wageni wote pale kwa hema. Watu wa chai pale. Sister Monica, pereka wageni wangu. Mr. Boniface, pereka wageni. Take care of my guests in Jesus' name.